What's up, everyone? I'm Ravioli Biceps. Welcome to my garage, an undisclosed location, redacted, unavailable, not on a map. I invited Sierra over to have a board session here and to get after it. Seen you in a minute. I feel like you've been climbing outside a bunch, you've been crushing. What have you been up to? What's your training like?
That's pretty much just it. It's been like moonboard, climb outside, climb some regular gym boulders here and there. But yeah, it's really just been like grinding, getting the training done, and then trying to send as many boulders that I'm psyched on as possible outside. But I'm really stoked for today's session. We had a session about a year and a half ago. Of course, we moonboarded. It was awesome.
Yeah.
And now I'm seeing the famous secret garage board today.
Yeah, that was 2019, so I got the 2016 set up, so we're going old school. We're gonna get our fingers destroyed and we'll get after it.
It's gonna be solid.
For me, I built this little box of pain, you know, mostly just so I could get like my fingers warm. Like, you always wanna get your fingers warm. So everything over here is like, you know, 8 to 10 millimeters and under. I have the Armstrong board over here that I'll make sure that I'm engaging on, you know, getting like my fingers ready. You don't really want to warm your fingers up on the board. Even if you're doing like 6B plus, 6C, you just want them ready for that engagement because you're going to be dynamic, fast, grabbing things, all the contact, strength, things like that. And then the two big things for me that I always, always do, shoulders and core. I always put some weight on my shoulders. I put some weight on my core and just get things going because I feel like that core all the way through to your toes, staying on the wall or staying on as long as you can till you cut. And then as far as shoulders, like having that stability and being able to typewriter left and right, like it's huge. So yeah, definitely get some weight on your shoulders, some rings, some little like 10 pound, 15 pound dumbbells, things like that, and get your core going. Decided to do some like classic benchmarks today. First one, weathering heights. That's the first problem that I put up on my board. It's like one of the most repeated. It's a Ben Moon classic. It's all white holds, and it's got kind of some interesting options. Like, you can match this like G13 pizza wedge if you want, but realistically, like, you have to do kind of a committing for V4 pull off of E15 at the end. So I think it's a classic. It's great.
So the next one we got on was Yaya Black, which is just a really cool hostock boulder, and it's all black holds. It's got some fun movement in it, and I think the coolest thing about it is it's like punchy, but it's to good hold. So I really like when you hit C13, it's just a friendly move. So whether you're, you know, projecting it or you're warming up on it, it's just nice. You know, you're not going to something small, and it really just kind of like gets you kicking for the rest of the session.
Yeah, and it's got that good, it's a really good representation of that satisfying like compression feeling between C13 and D15, like that tight compression on like good surface area holds.
Plus it ends on my favorite hold, which is D18.
Yeah, there you go, classic. Next one is a Kyle Knapp boulder, Full Moon Party. I think it's one of the first or like the highest repeated boulders that has the I-13 side pull. So really starting to, I mean, it's a straight side pull. It's vertical, you know, there's no cant to it. So you have to really just negotiate where your hips are gonna be and commit when you're going to E15. So it's just a good commitment boulder.
I think it's good too, because at the top, you feel like you're going pretty sideways. And it's just another thing that makes you feel like, you know, you're progressing towards like some of the harder movements while staying at a lower grade, you know, for the board.
Yeah. Next one's Pyro, Cardo Caperseca, classic. You know, one that stands out for me, like it's one of the earliest examples where you're going to be going into J9 as an undercling, and that builds you up for benchmarks later on where you're gonna go into I9, the black undercling right next to it to the left. Yeah, just good committing movement. You know, it's always a toss up if my foot's gonna slip on J9 or not, you know, when I'm making that big move out left.
And I really like that move on J9. I have the same thing where I feel like my foot's gonna slip and I'm just gonna go flying, but It's a boulder where I feel like when I do it, I know I'm starting to get really on with my core for the session. So I think it's good, whether it's this boulder or another one, to just have some boulders that you can gauge your warm up on.
So pixel bricks was one of the very first problems that I ever set. I had set maybe like 3 or 4. And like for reference, I think right now I've set like maybe a little over 100.
That's wild that it was like one of the first and it got benched too.
So it was one of the first, and then Kyle Knapp told me that he benched it years later. And I was like, oh, that's awesome. So this was my first set that got benchmarked. And now it's like, people just like hate it. They like love it and hate it. And like Mike Doyle like did it with like a meat hook right here. He like meat wrapped it to cross, but it's been kind of compared to overhead as well, which I think is like 7A or 7A plus.
Yeah, you gotta do it, you know?
Let's get it. Hell yeah. Sick. Oh, yeah. Love it. Oh, so like, yeah, your cross is at B.
Yeah, cool. It works pretty well.
Oh.
So I guess there's third beta I forgot to share.
Yeah, that is. That's cool. I also really like, and this is something I think you get, do you get this on the board where you're like, have to do like a move and then either put your foot really high or like stand in?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I feel like this one does it. Because like I do a high foot and really get up into it.
It's funny just how differently we climb it.
Oh yeah. The pixel bricks. And then you gotta do this too.
Oh yeah.
Like the bicycle. The unnecessary bicycle.
It's the style points though.
Yeah. Oh, I haven't climbed that in a long time.
Yeah, I feel like I do it every once in a while, like mainly because someone asked me to do it at the gym.
Like, can I see your beta? Yeah, so I mean, typically I think like after doing 5 roughly, you know, then I'll like jump into project level or like amp it up. But yeah, I think today you had a good idea to do some benchmarks that are kind of similar to each other, right? Like, so this is masterful gap.
Yeah.
But then I put a variation taking out C13 just like for fun, but then set it because I was like, oh, I think it'll be, it's kind of fun, satisfying to like do that jump. So yeah, we could do both of those and then try to find some other ones with some similarities.
Yeah. It's like you can get some of the harder moves on like the easier boulders, you know?
Yeah.
Which is just good training way, good like to build up your base.
Cool.
Sweet.
We'll crush it.
Let's get it done. Been a moonboarder since 2018, and it's really given me the biggest strength gains in my climbing, which is always exciting because who doesn't like to get stronger? And so what was kind of cool is I had that like big jump in like 2018 from the board, and I was still like moonboarding after that. But after I hurt my back about 2 years ago, I like really got into like moonboarding hard again because I didn't have to fall as far and I wasn't as scared to fall, and it's really just improved my climbing so much. And I'm so psyched on boarding. I always have been, but especially now it's like my bread and butter. Like I eat it for breakfast. Like the sessions that I'm the most psyched for are always board sessions. You know, if I'm gonna be on the board, I'm gonna be happy. Even if it's a bad session, right? I just always feel like I'm getting stronger, and yeah, I can't get enough of it. So it's so exciting to be here and just be sessioning.
See if I can maybe do an 8A at the end.
Yeah, I've only done up to a 10 on the board, so.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, even the 10s are all nails, but it's
oh,
like,
they're hard as hell.
Oh, yeah. Dude, it's just like nasty, like.
Yeah, you have to be like, okay, cool, I'm in like V13 mindset.
Yeah.
You know, to like.
Peak shape, having a great day.
Yeah. Yeah. Nice. Yeah. Hell yeah. Get that. Yeah, yeah. Sick. Yeah. Nice. It's a good sesh.
The fingers on that.
Yeah. That was sick.
Thanks. Dude, the one thing the board has taught me is my fingers can really not be on a hold and they can still stay. I used to like never be able to do this boulder, and then I did it a couple weeks ago and I haven't gotten on it since then, so it was cool to like fire it again.
Now you can just do it on repeat.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think I've done this thing since probably it was benched.
Oh dang.
I don't know when that was.
Like, it's been benched for a while.
Yeah, like years.
Yeah.
Sweet.
Nice.
I think that was like the big reel, you know, the big reel back.
Yeah.
That was good.
I feel like too, if anyone's trying to train for the alt version, it's like they can just do like, you know, the regular, or you can like move your hand down to like this stuff to just try and like drop it lower and lower.
Yeah. Oh yeah. That's a good point.
Like regardless of if you like do the heel or do the jump.
Yeah. Yeah, like, so that's, yeah, that's good for like the progression too. And then whether your heel or the jump, you have to load a ton on this right shoulder.
Yeah.
Like you said, like the latch on here, it's like a commitment latch because it's not like super ergonomic, but the top is, it has like purchase, you know?
Yeah.
So.
To be accurate about it.
Yeah. Yeah. I stand firm with the mic in my hand, calling out your phony niggas that be biting my man. Keep it up, you know I'm fed up, now it's time to go head up. I guess
this is good though, like I think it's gonna be fun to like transition into like just hard benchmarks that we either haven't done or haven't done in a while.
Alright. Do you flip C9 to do the C15 move?
Oh, like to a side pull?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I do.
Okay.
I can't remember. C9 is one of my favorites like on the board. I love that hold. It's so good. Nice. Hell yeah. Yeah. Come on. Yeah. That move to C15 and stuff. C15 is like one of the best placed holds.
Oh yeah.
It's like so good. Like when I was talking to like Sam and Dave and those guys that are setting the new set, mm-hmm. like this is what I was kind of trying to like conceptualize on the podcast talking to Sam and Aiden. I was like, this like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like, you know, whatever, 4x4, this spot has to be the best, like has to be amazing holds. Has to be like, you can use them from either direction, ergonomic, whatever, because like every problem I feel like goes through them, you know. You could even extend it out to like 5x5 or whatever.
Yeah,
this section is so important.
The best is when you can look at them on the app and you can like feel yourself climbing the boulder, like even a boulder you've never gotten on, you're like, I know what these moves would feel like.
Oh yeah.
What those holds feel like.
The cash in this underground industry, you just won't last. I said you just won't last.
So solid.
Oh yeah.
I was watching your left knee so hard on that. I was like what is it? So Sensei has been one of my nemesis boulders for probably like 5 years. And I've essentially always gotten to like where I'm going off of G11 to C15. And I know what happens when I do it. It's like my left knee hits the wall somehow. So I have to figure out like how to place my foot differently or just how to like move out of that position better. It's gonna go soon though. I felt really positive on that attempt. But yeah, this boulder's a beast. You know, it's a
classic.
It really is. I feel like it's one of the classic nines.
I think it's like the benchmark nine of the benchmark nines. It's like, okay, oh, you did Sensei, like, sweet, you're in it, you know?
Yeah. So whenever I try Sensei, I always want to like give it more than one burn because I'll feel like strong on it. But I don't know, it's a one burn boulder each session. Like, I have my best burn is my first burn, and then everything else after that just gets way worse.
Yes, this is Jer Bear Snare. This one's pretty infamous because it only uses the D column. Benched at 7C, so V9. Pretty absurd, like the throw from D8 to the D13 doorknob is like, it's just, you're swinging so far out, you know, you don't have any compression at all. You're just like really pulling down and it's side pull anyway. So we'll give it a rip. I think it got upgraded to 10, which is nice, generous, a rare benchmark upgrade.
Very generous of them.
Yeah. Oh, you hit it and then you have to be like a one arm off of it. At least the finish is good. He didn't make us cross to like C18.
Do you mind if I try it?
Yeah, give it a rip.
Let's see.
Yeah. It's hard for me to get my ass off the ground.
Dude, I know. It's like sometimes you just want the pads like carved a little.
Just a little bit, yeah.
Dude, that's like so far away.
It's funny because it's like, it looks like it's not, but when you sit down, you're like, it feels so far.
You're like, that's a solid 6 feet up the wall.
Yeah. Nice. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Get it. I like the match. I should consider the D8 match. Oh my god. How do you feel?
Oh dude, it was good. My heels dabbed on the concrete at the beginning and I was like, you know what, it's okay.
Yeah, it's fine.
I was like, I'm just gonna keep going.
I remember years and years ago, you know, and like you've been climbing a long time too, like, you know how like your style will like kind of change a little bit? Or like when you're an early climber, someone will like tell you your style and they'll be like, oh man, like, yeah, you're really good at this, or oh yeah, it looks like you're good at this. And like, I remember someone told me in Waco, they're like, oh yeah, you seem like you're good at compression. Then I was like, cool, that's all I do. You know,
I'm compression,
like,
man. Sweet.
Like, and then I was like, oh, I can't crimp, you know. Mm-hmm. And yeah, so I guess my advice would be like, you can do whatever, don't let someone pigeonhole you, you know?
That's true, because I've had numerous people tell me I look like I'd be a great sport climber, and
yeah,
I'm like, eh. Oh, dude.
So hard to latch it. Oh no, a spinner!
Oh no!
Oh no!
Do it!
Ah! Did you see it full spin? Look at this!
Oh my god.
Oh, all right. These things, like, you can feel it a little bit, like on the temperature drop. I think it like messes with it.
Oh, anytime the temperature changes, it like messes with all the holes.
Get it.
It's like everything starts flexing.
I think it's supposed to be like that-ish. Okay. All right, we'll take that as a sign next time.
So we're basically just getting on benchmark projects right now. This one is called Blair-Coyle Left, and I haven't tried it since July, so I'm curious to see how it's gonna go. I'm feeling pretty confident looking at it, but you know, there's a big difference from sitting on the ground and then actually climbing the boulder.
Sick. Yeah, really good. Nice. Yeah, you got it. Hell yeah. Nice.
Thanks, that was nice that happened.
Yeah, that was good. Now I gotta do the right one.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm gonna try Blair-Coyle Right, which is the original by Lorenzo, I think Carazio.
The original Blair-Coyle.
The original Blair-Coyle. Yeah, I can't remember. Is this a, it's been, I probably haven't done this since 2018. So is this a left and then a right?
I.
A right, then a left.
I, dude, can't, I think I did it like the dirty way, which was like, I'm fairly certain I did one of like these matched up.
Oh, you matched every one of them? Oh my God.
I think now I would not choose that path.
I think,
but
I'm gonna go here, here, and then try to stand and go up, I think. Where you go, the other option, there's a bunch of options here, which is kind of like makes it a classic. You know, it's like there's a ton of options. You could go left and then jump, but we'll see what's up.
It's just wild for how direct some of the lines are. That you have so many options on what to do. Like when you start watching beta videos, you'll see someone do something and you're like, man, I just never thought of that.
Yeah, I never thought of it. Like I never thought like to cross here or match this or swap this or whatever. That works. I was like, felt a little desperate to finish, but that was good.
That looks solid.
Yeah, that's nice to get that Gastone. Mm-hmm. It's got a nice bite on it. I-15. All right, thanks for joining us. I'm wrecked. How do you feel?
Yeah, dude, I'm pretty beat up here.
Yeah, for sure, but it was good, and yeah, look forward to having you next time.
Yeah, psyched. Thanks for joining us for a session.